Thank you very much for joining us for the 2022 Spring Concert. We're very excited to have you and excited to play and sing, and thank you for being a part of all of this. It feels really good to be back in here for our Spring Concert, so we're all very excited about it. If you want to give extra hugs and high fives to the seniors, these guys have put a lot of work in. They've all worked so hard, and I was telling the orchestra just a couple minutes ago, like, we're getting ready and warming up and writing through our own music, and I was like, man, you guys just make me so fortunate to, like, have the job that I do. It's just very cool and very special, so thank you for letting me be a part of this, too. We're going to go ahead and get started with orchestra, and then band, and then choir, and relax and enjoy. All right, thank you.
Thank you.
appreciate your enthusiasm to come play, but you may actually sit down for a brief moment. Well, they grab all the instruments. You can sit. There are 7 students on stage that have put in a whole lot of work and a whole lot of, more importantly, art over the past 4 years. Very, very fortunate to have gotten to know them, not only just as my students that come in the room, but just as people. They are amazing, amazing people. So to their families and friends, thank you for encouraging them and having them part of our program. And to you guys, I couldn't thank you enough. It's truly been a privilege. Will the following students please stand together? Isabel Caruana, Gabby Marcoux, Sophia Long, Elena Powers, Ali Wada, Kira Donor, and Ainsley Samples.
Yeah, Gabby!
Basis, thank you for continuing to stand for all 4 years. But really though, they've been phenomenal. All of these groups have been amazing. I'm sure that you've heard of the infamous band room chats, orchestra tea time, where we, you know, the kids have been doing a really exceptional job this year. They've been practicing constantly. I don't think there are so many students that are in our tea time class that they're like, can I go work on something? So like, the band room is really loud this year. I'm like, they like to practice, it's so great. But they've been amazing, they've been phenomenal. I'm very excited to continue to work with the students that I'm fortunate enough to work with next year. And without further ado, band, you may now get your instruments. And thank you, orchestra. Picking music for MSPOA Festival, and there were 2 marches that were like our reach piece marches. Like, these are a little tough, but like, we can do it if we go for it. And we decided to play a different one for a festival, and I said, well, we really like this piece though, do you think this is something we could do for the spring concert? And we said, well, it's not very springy, but like, do we care? No, but because it's a cool piece. So it's called The Viking. It's a recent commission. It is technically a band march. It does not sound like a band march. It is also featuring our lovely senior pianist, Miss Elena Powers, over there. Thank you.
Thank you.
second class, obviously we've got our seniors. These students put in an exorbitant amount of work. They've done concert band, they've done marching band. One time we tried to have jazz band. Some of them also do orchestra, and some of them do percussion ensemble. They do a lot of work, same as orchestra. I'm just really privileged to have gotten to know them. I remember walking into their middle school classrooms to go, come sign up for band and orchestra when they were like 12, and now they're graduating. So it's like, it's very, very bittersweet, but like from the bottom of my heart, thank you. It really has been, it's been beautiful. You guys have been great. You drive me nuts and I love you all at the same time, year after year. So I would like to acknowledge the following students. Najee Nasser, Mustafa Al-Samari, right? Sami Al-Faki, Ali Awada, Dahlia Hazimi, Lizzie Kowalski, Shelby Opalka, Xavier Blair, they stand. And Kira Donner, continue standing. Intermission. Okay, there are concessions in the hallway. You are more than welcome to them. There is also a donation drum out there if you choose to donate to the performing arts. These go towards things like the performing arts banquet on June 2nd. Performing arts banquet on June 2nd at 6 p.m. in the cafeteria. Please join us. And in the meantime, you may help yourselves to snacks. They're in the main hallway while we get set up for choir. Thank you so much.
Jackson's give one of our seniors, Danielle Frontera. Can't go wrong with a little Beatles, right? So, we have a strong female presence this year. We did some explorations of some different pieces, and we did want to pay a little tribute to some of the women who brought forth some of the sounds of our girl groups, as we used to call them. That's probably not PC. And we have a song by the Cordettes, Lollipop. Second song, Larger Than Life, comes from a very prolific composer that won't share who they are. It's very secret, and we don't know who they are, but under the nom de plume, the pen name Pink Zebra, we have some extremely uplifting and positive, fun songs to sing. Some thoughts in Larger Than Life are all the dreams that we hope for our students, and we hope that they hope for themselves, and we hope for you as well. Larger Than Life. to be able to offer a couple, it's traditional for our seniors to prepare senior solos, and tonight we will have one more senior solo from Yamisha Bell. Tell you a little bit about our seniors. We got to hear them. We're going to have quiet box 3 and pull that cover down. Needless to say, we're still working without our own sound system and soundboard, so it's a little still iffy. All right, before we sing the next step, just a brief moment to thank these young ladies for their work in our department. Yamisha had to fight counselors and schedules and everything else to get herself back in choir for this semester, and we are really pleased she was with us. And I can't say enough about Danielle, so I just won't say anything. Just kidding. No. Danielle is an inquirer. Danielle just shows up because she loves to sing and be with our performing arts family. She knows what family means, and she's always been there as my right and my left hand to take care of things since we've gotten back in school, and I haven't been able to be here as much. So I've thrown a lot of responsibilities on these students, and they have really rose to the occasion, and I'm very proud. To sing an arrangement of How Can I Keep From Singing. I invite all former choir members and anybody who wants to look at the music and come sing with us to come forward. We historically, before the pandemic, I was able to have those students who can't fit choir into their schedule, which is quite a number of students. We used to be able to have a tea time choir. I'm not allowed to be in the building except for the first 2 hours, and I have to go to another building. So I can't offer that to them anymore. However, some of our students who were in that tea time choir and have been in our theater program have offered to come in, and they're gonna sing along with us. And this is a song that has been sung here for at least 25 years. It was instituted by my predecessor, and I've kept it up in it, and we've had many, many alumni come back and sing with us over the years. We lost a lot when we were at home. We lost this tradition. We lost many of our traditions. So if you can feel good about reading music and come on up and sing, please do. Please sing from your seats. Please just sing, because how can we keep from singing?
Thank you.